In this video, we're going to do the KutaSoftware worksheet MultiStep Equations under the free worksheets in Infinite Algebra 1. Now the directions for this are to solve each equation. And for the sake of time so I don't have an extremely long video, I'm going to split this up into three separate videos. So the first one we'll do numbers 1 through 7, and then we'll do 8 through 14, and finish out with 15 through 20. So in the first video, let's get started with number 1. Now before we get started, I also want to make a note that since these are multi-step equations, there's different orders in which you can do the steps. So I'm going to try to mix it up and do a couple different ways, but feel free to do whichever way is most comfortable for you. So for number 1, we have negative 20 equals negative 4x minus 6x. We're going to start by combining like terms. So negative 4x minus 6x is going to go further into the negatives. So this is going to be negative 20 equal to negative 10x. So now, like a one-step equation, we're just going to divide by negative 10. Negative divided by negative is a positive. So we'll get 2 on the left-hand side. Negative 10 divided by negative 10 is a positive 1. 1 times x is x. So 2 is equal to x. Number 2, we have 6 equal to 1 minus 2n plus 5. I'm going to start by combining like terms on the right-hand side of this equation. Combining the positive 1 and the positive 5, I'm going to have 6 equals 6 minus 2n. Then I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides to get 0 equal to, remember this is minus 2n, so it's going to be a negative 2n. Since it's 0 minus 2n, that's the same as 0 plus a negative 2n, which is simply negative 2n. Then I'm going to divide by negative 2 on both sides, and we'll get that 0 is equal to n. Because 0 divided by negative 2 is 0, and negative 2 divided by negative 2 is 1, and 1 times n is n. So 0 is the answer for number 2. Number 3, 8x minus 2 equals negative 9 plus 7x. I'm going to pick a side that I want my x's to be on. So I'm going to move any term with x to the left-hand side, and anything without an x to the right-hand side. For my first step, I'm going to subtract 7x from both sides, and at the same time, I'm going to add a 2 to both sides. 8x minus 7x is 1x minus 2, and this is the same as adding a negative 2, so negative 2 plus 2 is 0, and then negative 9 plus 2 is a negative 7, plus 7x minus 7x is a 0. This leaves us with 1x, which is x, equal to negative 7. Since 1x plus 0 is x, and negative 7 plus 0 is negative 7. If you were uncomfortable taking away 7x and adding 2 all in the same step, go ahead and take away 7x from both sides to start, and then add 2. You don't have to do it all in one step, I just do that to conserve space. Number 4, we have 8 plus 5 is equal to negative 5a plus 5. So I'm going to start by subtracting 5 from both sides. If I subtract 5 from both sides, I'll be left with an a on the left-hand side is equal to a negative 5a on the right-hand side. Now I can move this a or this negative 5a to either side. I'll go ahead and add 5a to both sides. A plus 5a is 6a, and negative 5a plus 5a is 0. My last step would be to divide by 6. That'll give me a equal to 0 for number 4. Number 5, 4m minus 4 equals 4m. I'm going to start by subtracting this 4m. So when I subtract 4m from both sides, I'm left with a negative 4 on the left, since it was subtracted originally, equal to 4m minus 4m is 0. But wait a second, negative 4 cannot equal 0. Therefore, there is no solution to number 5. That means there is no value that we can plug in for m that will make this equation true. Therefore, there is no solution. And you can see right off the bat, if you have 4m and you're taking away 4 from that, but you have that equaling the original starting value, that's not possible. So you can see logically that there's no solution at the very beginning without even doing any math. Moving on to number 6, we have p minus 1 equals 5p plus 3p minus 8. I'm going to start by combining like terms on the right hand side. That'll leave me with p minus 1 on the left equal to 8p minus 8 on the right. Then I'm going to move this p over to the right so that I have negative 1 remaining. And I'm going to move this negative 8 over to the left so I only have a p remaining. And I'll go ahead and do that in one single step. So subtracting p from both sides and adding 8. To both sides. P minus P is 0, so I have 0, and then a negative 1 plus 8 will be a positive 7, and that's going to be equal to 8P minus 1P, which is 7P plus 0. So 7 equals 7P, and when we divide by 7 on both sides, we get that 1 is equal to p. And we're going to end on number 7. But before we finish this out, go ahead and give me a thumbs up on this video. And if you have further questions, go ahead and comment below. And also, if you're still confused, practice, practice, practice. Go back to the one-step equations, go back to the combining like terms worksheet, go back to the two-step equation worksheet, and work through those problems again if necessary. Also, go to my tutorial section, where I go through a more in-depth explanation of solving these multi-step equations. But this is just the practice, so watch that video before you do the worksheet. Now for number 7. I'm going to subtract a 5p from both sides, and that'll leave me with 0p, or 0. And on this side, I'll have 3p left. And I'm also going to take away 4 from both sides. A negative 14, since this 14 is being subtracted, minus 4 is going to be a negative 18. And that's equal to 3p. 4 minus 4 is 0. So we have negative 18 equals 3p. So we divide by 3. We're going to get that negative 6 is equal to p. So negative 6 is the solution for number 7. And in the next video, we're going to start with number 8 and go all the way through number 14.